medications are chemicals. And when we put those into our bodies, they are potentially dangerous. And so we need to be aware of the adverse events that can happen with any medication that we take. In this video, we'll be looking at the different classifications of adverse events and what that means to you as a healthcare provider right after this. Welcome back. My name is Tammy, and this is Nurse Minder, and on this channel, we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. Welcome back. Before we get started, be sure to like, subscribe, and comment below at the end of this video to let me know if this has been helpful for you. And if you have ideas for future videos, please send those in. Now, an adverse event is an undesirable outcome, and it can range from just a slight unpleasant taste in your mouth or a little nausea in your stomach to a life-threatening condition. So we're first going to take a look at the primary adverse event category. In a primary action, what's happening here is we actually have an extension of the desired effect. So for example, if you take a blood pressure medication to lower your blood pressure, and it works so well that it lowers it too far, that would be considered an extension of the desired outcome, and that can cause a patient some concern. Now, there are reasons why this might happen. We consider this sometimes to be a simple overdose in the sense that the drug's dosing is correct for your condition and your situation and your person and your age and all those things, but your body's response is more sensitive than we would have anticipated. Now, the effects on an individual can be different for a variety of reasons. Sometimes it's the patient's age, happens to deal with the patient's weight, maybe underlying conditions that affect how that drug works in your body. When it comes to secondary effects, these are considered in addition to the desired effects. So when we're doing our patient education, example for that blood pressure medication, we let them know that they're getting this particular medication because it acts on this site and the end result is to lower your blood pressure. We also need to tell them that there are other side effects with this medication. For example, if my blood pressure gets too low, I might be tired and dizzy, confused, but there's also the fact that I'm taking this pill orally and my stomach may not like that, so I can have nausea with that. And if my heart slows down or my blood pressure lowers enough, I may end up having some edema. So these are considered in addition to effects. This is not the desired intention, but they may be things that happen as a result of getting the desired intention. We may be able to manage some of these undesirable adverse events by adjusting the dose here. Unlikely that we can eliminate all risk, so education and letting our patients know what they might expect and when to come back is important for you to know as a nurse caring for your patient. In hypersensitivity reactions, what we're seeing is a heightened response to either the primary or the secondary reactions that we're seeing now present in our patients who have a hypersensitivity to the medication. There are some things that we need to consider that will put our patients at risk. What is the underlying pathology of that patient? There may be a condition that is impacting how that medication can work. If you recall back in a previous video when we talked about pharmacodynamics and pharmacokinetics, if a patient has a proton pump inhibitor, it is impacting how a medication can be absorbed. With age, sometimes those receptors are known to become more sensitive to drugs. And even though we maybe have a desired outcome of lower blood pressure in giving a blood pressure medication, we may find that there's an opposite reaction. This happens a lot with narcotics and medications that are used to decrease the awakeness and alertness of our patients to lower their anxiety. Sometimes they become more anxious. So age, we see that often in our geriatric population. Liver and kidney function. We know that the liver is a huge organ for metabolism, as is the lungs. Kidney is a major place where we excrete our medication. So if there's any pathology there, we may end up having a toxic buildup, and then we'll end up having a hypersensitivity reaction in our patient. Drug allergies is the fourth classification of adverse events. I want to spend a little bit more time on this, because this is where our body is actually launching an immune response and forming antibodies to the medication that we've just ingested or infused. Many times our patients will say they have an allergy to a drug in particular. We need to actually determine if it's a true allergy. So So for example, if we're giving that ACE inhibitor and the blood pressure is so low that they get, when they wake up in the morning and sit up, they feel confused and they faint, they may think that's an allergy. But really, that's education about side effects, primary and secondary, and then how to manage that and treat that. So not to get up so quickly, to let just sit for a little while, let the dizziness go away, things like that. If it's a true allergy, and there are some rare allergies, for example, like ACE inhibitors, angioedema can be a life-threatening allergy that patients experience, swelling of the face, numbness and tingling, and about 20 to 40% of ER visits related to angioedema are traced back to ACE inhibitors. So understanding the definition of a true allergy versus an adverse event is important in terms of caring for your patient holistically. So there's four classifications of allergies: anaphylactic, cytotoxic, serum sickness, and delayed allergy reaction. Now it's important to note that a patient cannot be allergic to a medication they have never taken. However, there can be cross-sensitivity. So if you have a particular class of antibiotics and they've reacted to one medication in that classification, it is likely they will react to the others, or you would expect to see a potential reaction. So let's start with anaphylactic. This is a life-threatening reaction where the airway becomes swollen and they cannot swallow. The first type we're going to look at is anaphylactic because it's the most serious. This is a life-threatening reaction to a stimulus, like bee stings. Histamine and other chemicals are released at the site and cause immediate swelling. You may also notice itching, rashes, lower blood pressure. These need to be treated right away, and this is where you often hear those public service announcements and commercials about epinephrine for those who have life-threatening allergies to peanuts, shellfish, things like that. So EpiPens are something you will see carried by those who have known reactions to specific antigens that are life-threatening in nature. In cytotoxic allergic reactions, what's happening here is that there's cell death occurring because it's kind of a mistaken identity. So we have taken this medication and it's bound to the cell. Let me get rid of this here. This is our cell and its receptor site, and here's the medication we want to take. So say if it's an antibiotic, it has bound to the cell that we want it to work with. IgG, one of our immunoglobulins, comes along and it mistakenly identifies this as a foreign body and then it destroys it. So cytotoxic antibodies are circulating and they mistakenly identify the good guys as bad guys and then they destroy them. We often see this show up in blood work. Now, when our system is not working to its capacity and we end up having a lot of antigen-antibody complexes in the body, they're not able to be cleared effectively because the system is overrun. So what happens is that these tend to clump together then in serum sickness syndrome, and they end up depositing in the vasculature and in the joints of patients. So we end up having several days to weeks later, a patient will present with polyarthralgia, so multiple joints that are painful and swollen, there may be rashes. So in this case, as with all of these cases, we would stop the medication, symptomatic control, and wait for further instructions. A delayed allergic reaction, again, is not happening immediately. There's some time that goes from the insult to the reaction, and we're going to see a delayed, there may be a rash, pain, and swelling, such as your first bee sting. You maybe didn't react right away, but the next day you wake up and you notice there's a bit of swelling and redness at the site, that would be considered a delayed reaction. So that's a quick overview of the different types of adverse events that we can plan and prepare for when we give our patients medications. Having this knowledge will help you anticipate potential danger in the upcoming days to weeks after we give treatment to our patients. As always, make sure you like, subscribe, and comment below. Let me know if this video was helpful. And until next time, make it a great day.